Okay, now that we've described what a polar curve is, curves in polar coordinates, where we have the radius as a function of theta, what we want to do is we want to do calculus with these polar curves. We want to figure out how do you get the slope of a tangent line, that is dy dx, if somebody just gives you r as a function of theta. And the key is to think of it as a parametrized curve. See, if we just let, we can call a parameter t, and we just let theta equal t. And then r is f of theta, which is just f of t. And that tells us what x and y are, because x is r cosine theta, that's f of t cosine theta, and y is r sine theta, so that's f of t sine theta. So now that we've got x and y as functions of t, we can take the derivatives. The derivative of y is f of t cosine of t, since the derivative of sine is cosine, plus f prime of t sine of t, just by the product rule. And the derivative of x is minus f sine of t plus f prime cosine of t. And then, if you know dy dt and dx dt, you take their ratio, and you get dy dx. Okay, it's an ugly formula, but it's a formula. And it's often easier to just express everything back again in terms of r and theta, because after all, f of t is the same thing as r, and t is the same thing as cosine of theta, because t is just theta. In fact, we could have called our parameter theta to begin with, but we're used to calling our parameter t, so I wrote everything in terms of t. So you always want r cosine theta plus r prime, and by r prime I mean the derivative of r with respect to theta, and we have this whole expression. So let's use this on a couple of examples. So there we are, put a box around it. We'll use this in a couple of examples and figure out the slopes of some curves. So the first example is we want to look at a circle. Just take a circle of radius 2, and we want to compute the slope of the tangent line as a function of where you are in the circle. Well, that's pretty easy. R is 2, so R prime is 0. Our formula says R cosine theta plus R prime sine theta over that, you know, r prime is 0, so you just get the r's cancel, and you just wind up with minus the cotangent of theta. This should make sense geometrically, because here we have our circle, and we're looking at what's happening at angle theta, and the line that heads out like this, the slope of this line is the tangent of theta. The line we're interested in is perpendicular to that, and it has a slope of negative cotangent of theta. You may remember that when you want to take up the perpendicular to a line, you take minus the reciprocal of the slope. Minus the reciprocal of tangent of theta is negative cotangent of theta. Okay. For our next example, we're going to look at a curve that's called a cardioid. Cardioid is r equals 1 plus sine theta. And it looks like this. If we'd done 1 minus sine theta, it would have looked like a heart, which is why it's called a cardioid. Now it looks like an upside down heart. And we want to figure out what is the slope of the tangent line when theta equals pi over 4. Again, it's just plug and chug. R is 1 plus sine theta. The derivative of that is r prime is cosine theta. And then we just plug and chug. Dy dx, here's our formula. R is 1 plus sine theta times cosine theta. R prime is cosine theta times sine. We collect terms. We get this whole ugly expression, and in the end, that works out to negative 1 plus root 2. So, it's not an especially enlightening calculation. It's a formula. You plug into the formula, but If you can do this problem, you can do almost any problem.